Okay, go ahead,
now,
Nikki.
Say it all. Is it on? Say it all again.
Okay. Yes. So we want to make sure that Bob gets his presentation in. So please welcome me and welcome. Please join me in welcoming Mr. Bob Jones from Image Perfection. Yay!
Thank you. I go on the internet as Mr. Bob, and I'm internationally known out there. I've got an international following. I do big screens, I do home theater, I do all things with the home theater experience. I think what I want to talk about today is, do you know if you're getting high definition or not? It's a very simple clue. There's a lot of people that I felt like they didn't know they weren't getting high definition. There are many ways to connect up. One of them is like this with the yellow, red, and white. That won't do it, okay? You don't get anything close to high definition with this kind of connection. If you use this kind of connection, that's video. That won't do it either. That's standard definition stuff. Component, red, green, and blue. That'll do it. HDMI, that'll do it. There's also TVI, that'll do it. I've seen cable installers get this wrong. So make sure you're getting HD. Now when I come to your place, I'm going to find out immediately if you're getting HD. But you got to get me to your place first. I'm going to make this an extended question and answer session because there is so much I can talk about. I really don't want to narrow it down. So I'm going to open it up to questions early on. And what can I say? There's one.
So you're talking about these types of things. So I'm under the impression, because I'm an office, that one connection goes into the TV. Where does the other connection go?
The other connection comes from your source. Your source can be a set-top box, a cable, or satellite. It can be a Blu-ray player. It can be a DVHS VCR, which is digital, which is also high definition. It has to come from there to your display intact. That's high definition, just say high definition. If you're using an AVR, an audio video receiver, you can switch between one device and another device. That has to be HDMI ready. And you quickly copy it. When they came up with HDMI, they did that so that things can't be pirated. Sometimes they can't go through an AVR. You have to get another kind of switcher. So, to a switcher, or to your device, or straight to your device. Does that answer your question?
Yes, thank you.
Great.
Another question. So, if we buy a new high-definition TV, and it comes to our house, and they plug in our old cables, we're not getting high-definition, are we?
Absolutely not.
No. So when we buy a new TV, we need to have other accessories that you know about, right?
Yes. If you go to Best Buy, yeah, Christmas is on the way. So a lot of people are going to go down to the Best Buy or wherever they can get a good deal, fries. They're going to come home with a big pile of stuff. They're going to look at that and they're going to say, oh my God, what do I do now? That's what you call me. This stuff can be very, even for me, it can be taxing. It can take all afternoon to hook up your system. The receivers these days have menus built into the receivers. And to see some of these menus, you have to hook up an output of that receiver to your display, to your low definition display, just to see the graphics of what you're supposed to be doing to get things to go right. One of our people, our treasurer in the same chapter in Castro Valley, he asked me when I spoke over from the TIP meeting, what about surround sound? It doesn't sound right. Well, he was being lied to by his display. I said, all these displays these days, all these AV receivers these days, have ways to go in there and you can adjust the various speakers to various levels. Well, the speaker he wanted most was the center channel. He wasn't hearing anything. According to their test, it was fine. We had to crank it up 9 points to get it to work. Sometimes these things lie to you. They can be very sophisticated. You may not want to deal with it. So that's something I specialize in. Go ahead.
Let's say somebody buys a size 7 man.
No chair broken today.
What's this your head, Dave?
If somebody buys an HD TV for Christmas, and you had
Well, when I'm installing the system, it's hard to know how long it'll take.
Yeah.
So I don't just do a blanket thing. If I'm repairing a TV, I do give you a blanket estimate, regardless of the time span. But when I'm installing something, I really don't know. I typically charge $95 an hour to come to you. Yeah. For a tip, members, I give this one.
But when you come for an installation,
Castro Valley Chamber of Commerce.
When you come to the house to do an installation, once you see the equipment, can you then give an estimate?
I prefer to do it on a kind of a block basis, like let's spend an hour, see if it does it all. If it doesn't, we'll do another hour. I like to do it hour by hour. Sometimes I have to tell people, let's just do a 4-hour block now, and then we'll see what's left.
Do you have a minimum?
Yeah, 1 hour. And travel time, sometimes travel time.
So
I'm a fan of the older televisions, the big, thick kind. They can produce the best high definition out there. Not many people know that.
You're kidding.
Spread the word, tell your friends, if they have one of these old,
the big, tall ones,
don't go out and buy a new flat panel.
My husband, every single Sunday I get up and go to the dining room table, and Mary's got Best Buy, and he's got his television. And we've got one of the big old boxes, he's got HDMI.
You should come over and see my big old thick one. It'll blow you away. Knock your socks off. This is my
$2,500.
Glad to do it.
Get his certificate.
This is my new business card. This is a photograph of my TV in action with an HD image on it.
Can I keep this?
Yes.
Excuse me, craft salad to go.
That's my TV at home. It's a CRT, the old thing. But they are so tunable, it's amazing. I could sit there and watch the grain of the film. They used to shoot the movie you're watching and study the grain of that film.
We have time for one more question.
Okay.
Go ahead.
Could you tell us about the big TVs, how you clean the graphics to make them look better? The lenses?
How I clean the lenses?
Yes. Just why?
CRT-based TVs use 30,000 volts. That turns the whole thing into a gigantic ionizer. It literally sucks all the particulates in the air out of the air, puts them on the closest smooth surface, which is 3 lenses and a mirror. Sometimes it gets down under those lenses, and there's 6 more surfaces that need cleaning. After about 5 years, your set looks so blurry, you want a new one. Retailers want you to buy a new one. You don't need to do that. Just have you clean it all up. There's 28 optical surfaces in there. When they're all clean again, it looks amazing. It looks brand new. This is a prime example. I did that for you. Thank you so much, everybody.
Thank you.